The bike is actually hooked up 100% stock right now, and what we're going to do is we're real quickly just going to show how we hook up and test the battery. So first off, a DC, one of our meters here on DC volts. So what we show here, this is a maintenance-free battery, and we're showing 12.55 volts. Realistically, that's a little low, but we've started the bike a couple of times, which means we've kind of drained some of that surface voltage off. What we do not want to do is, let me get that on there a little better, get that out of the way. What we don't want to do is consider that that means the battery's good, okay? So what, from there, what we do is we do a traditional method of a load tester. And with this load tester, we could take and we put these heavy duty clamps on here, once again, battery out of the machine. And this gives us our surface voltage reading. And then when I hit this button here, what that does is it cranks down an internal load on the battery to see if the battery doesn't fall less than 9 volts, okay? If it falls less than 9 volts, as you can see, it's gonna register bad. Maintenance-free batteries typically fall to about 10 volts. Conventional batteries fall to that 9 range, and then it just holds there. If it leaks down, the battery either needs charge to replace, and you can see some of our other videos for that. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and use the bike starter as a way to measure the load testing of this battery. So let's bring this meter closer here. Why don't you go ahead and just set it like that. You could see, obviously, we're hooked up. You could see what our voltage is. I'm gonna go ahead and start the motorcycle. And what we're looking for on the load testing here, why don't you students tell me, is we want no less than what?
9 volts.
So as we crank this over with the starter, if that gets less than 9 volts, we have a battery issue of just needing charged or replaced. So let's check out and see what happens.